What are you doing? Come here. Come on. Come. Come. Oh, you got a snack? Got a snack? Good boy.
I love democracy. I love the republic.
The main thing is to protect these characters. Make sure that they still continue to live in the way that you created them, and that the universe of Star Wars continues to grow.
So, who is Luthen Rael? Welcome back to the Cantina, everybody. This is Stephanie Janicek. Also, please remember there is a fundraiser going on so I can upgrade my studio. And every little bit helps. There will be a link in the description and a pinned comment with the link as well. And also in the live stream. So, who is Luthen Rael? Luthen Rael is played by the remarkable Stellan Skarsgård, and he brings something different to Star Wars. A lot of people have been complaining about the fact that Star Wars doesn't feel like Star Wars. Well, episode 4 at least gave us some hint. And we did get another hint before when Rael gives Cassian Andor a very valuable and troublesome artifact, a blue kyber crystal. Of course, blue is a color of Jedi lightsaber. But what does it say about who Rael is? Is he like Mon Mothma, where he wants to return the Jedi to... Could it be that simple? Or is he playing at another game? The first indication that he is more than just a go-between Mothma and the disparate elements of the growing rebellion is this, the blue kyber crystal he gives to Cassian Andor. That would belong to a Jedi. That would go into his lightsaber. Think about Anakin Skywalker. Think of any Jedi out there. Think of what's inside their lightsaber, and this would be it. So why does Rael have this? And why does he say to Andor, you could get over 50,000 credits for this, but to me, it's everything. It means more than that. Why does he say that? These are all little clues as to who he really is. And I think we need to discuss that deeper, because he's going to be a turning point, I think, for everything. And of course, his ship, here we are on Mount Hani, is a throwaway design for the Millennium Falcon. If you look at it, it even kind of looks like an old World War II ship. And of course, here we are talking to the leader here about Andor, and she doesn't want him. Rael says, you're taking him. And when Andor asks who Rael is, she said, that's something we don't discuss, we don't talk about him. So she knows. So we get back to the ship, landing on Coruscant, and Rael puts on a wig and becomes this guy. So who is he? Why is an antiques dealer who comes across as effeminate, whose hair is long, who wears the kind of the same outfits to resemble the Emperor, who is he? He really does work hard at dressing like Palpatine. From the purple robes and the rings to the longish graying wig, he resembles Palpatine. Because probably he wants to fit in to what Coruscant-y loyal Imperials perceive themselves to want to be, to look like a dilettante, upper crust, elitist, Imperial loyalist. And he also takes on a very effete persona. Mon Mothma here knows there's more to it and knows him more than many, okay? Knows him probably better than anybody because she knows his true self. And I have a lot of ideas. Many other people brought this up. Who is he? The kyber crystal he gave to Andor is important. This picture right here is the real Luthen Rael. Even looking at what he's wearing here is an echo, a mirror of what Rebel Alliance generals like Carlos Dreykin and Draven and others will be wearing. He's wearing their colors. But these are also, if you look at the mix of colors, there are also a bit of Jedi in that. So who is he? Well, one person out there thinks he's actually a Jedi hiding in plain sight. And he could be. That makes a lot of sense. Kyber crystal, it means more to him than anything. Maybe it's his own kyber crystal. Okay. Maybe having a lightsaber would have been a dead giveaway. So he's literally shedding all of his Jedi persona on Coruscant to fit in. So he can go about the business of the beginnings of the dismantling of Palpatine's empire. He could also be the first fulcrum. Okay, look in his shop, and he has friezes from a Jedi temple. They may or may not be from Lothal. They might even be from the Jedi temple on Coruscant, where it maps out the world between worlds. Okay, think about that. I want you to think about that, because if he's the first fulcrum, this is a connection to Ahsoka, Rebels, and also because we got to meet kind of the world between worlds and the Mortis arc and Clone Wars. Okay. So is he the first fulcrum? Is he a Jedi hiding in plain sight? Both could actually be true. Neither could be true. But there are indications that he holds, just by what's in his shop, which I'm going to repeat, are proscribed to the general public, but what he's got there, the Sith Hunter, Sith Stalker armor, and other things, what he's got there, Mandalorian armor, what he's got there is not something the general public, the people living on the second levels of and third levels of Coruscant could afford. Again, when Mon Mothma's driver says, I couldn't afford anything in this shop, he's telling you something about elite and titles who live on the very first level of Coruscant and everybody else. Okay. There's a great line from a fan fiction where Lando Calrissian is looking at one of Vader's officers and looks at him and looks. The guy's pale, pasty. He's never actually been out in the sun. Coruscant-y, born and bred. These are the kinds of people that are in the elite, effete, loyalist, imperial, dominated Coruscant at this time. These are Luthen Rael's customers. And this is the perfect place for someone who's got business doing bad things to the Empire to hide in plain sight. He can use the money he makes from selling Utapau and Kugel's monk, clubs to give the rebellion money and cash. He is the link between all the disparate guerrilla groups. And this is why he's so important. So the nickname or the codename Fulcrum makes sense here. But let's talk about this again. The Kyber crystal, the fact that there's a Jedi holocron and a Sith holocron in one of the scenes. And of course, the artifacts from the Jedi temple tell me he's more than just a gatherer of the angry, disaffected population. To me, he's more than that, because like Mon Mothma, he basically, by what he's got in the office and by the fact he carried that blue crystal, tells me he reveres the Jedi and the Republic. But I think he is more than just the go-between. I think he's probably the leader. I also think he's a Jedi. That's what I think. Anyway, this is Steph signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.